Praise the Lord. Welcome this Sunday as I share the message today. Shall we pray? Lord, we thank and praise you for this day, Lord Jesus, for your word which is sharper than two-edged sword, O Father. Lord, I pray right now, be with us, Lord, as we listen, Lord. Lord, touch my lips and let your will be done, that we will hear from thee, O God. Thank you for your grace. In Jesus' name. Amen. Today's text I have taken from the Hebrews chapter 11, verse 23. It says, by faith Moses' parents hid him for 3 months after he was born, because they saw he was no ordinary child, and they were not afraid of the king's edict. We see that Moses is sent as the foreshadow of Christ. And this morning I would like to share actually on the life of Moses' mother and his sister. And I would like to share this word from the book of Exodus chapter 2, verse 1 to 10. And this is what exactly happened, is that he was born. But let me give you a background before his birth, what was happened. Israelites, Jacob with his family of 72, moved into Egypt when Joseph was the prime minister. At a lapse of time of approximately 400 years have passed, and God blessed Israel or Jacob's family as he had promised to his friend Abraham, that I will multiply your seed. And therefore, the Israelites have grown in number so much so that Pharaoh, the king of Egypt, was afraid that they might take over his country. There are two theories that we need to understand. One is that this Pharaoh was afraid of Israelites because of their growth in number. Second theory is, as scholars say, maybe there was a change in dynasty which took place during this time. Because Exodus chapter 1 says that a king arose in Egypt who did not know Joseph. And therefore, out of fear, this king of Pharaoh orders in chapter 1, verse number 16, to the midwives, what does he say? He says, when you help the Hebrew women in childbirth and observe them on the delivery stool, if it is a boy, kill him. But if it is a girl, let her live. This was an order by the Pharaoh to who? The midwives. And during this time, if Moses was born. During this time, Moses was born. And he was a fine looking child that his mother hid him for 3 months, and thereafter she could not hide him. Let me share few thoughts on the life of his mother and his sister. When he grew up about 3 months, you see that children, when they grow up, they start moving around, they make more noise than while they are still a baby. Therefore, Moses could not be hidden for a long time. Therefore, his mother made a basket. It says here, verse 3, chapter 2, Exodus chapter 2, verse 3 says, where she could hide him no longer, she got a papyrus basket for him and coated it with tar and pitch. Then she placed the child in it and put it in it among the reeds along the bank of river Nile. That's exactly what she did. You see, when God works in our life, and when God has a plan and purpose for someone's life, like Moses or your life or my life, He provides and He allows us to go through some difficult times. Difficult times may be there for a short time. The song says, the night could be a night of difficulty and crying, but what happens in the morning at the dawn, there is happiness and light. So most probably this was the time when she was facing her darkest hour. Imagine how difficult it is for a mother to part with her suckling baby of 3 months and putting him in the river or among the reeds of the river. Blessings cannot be hidden. I want you to share a thought that blessings cannot be hidden. He was a blessing. Moses was a blessing to his parents from God. As we read, he was no extraordinary baby. As we read from the book of Hebrews, right? Chapter 11, verse 23. He was no ordinary baby. So blessings cannot be hidden. They tried to hide Moses for 3 months, but they could not, or he could not be hidden. We need to understand when God gives us a blessing, that blessing is overflowing full. Therefore, it's like pressed down, filled to the brim, overflowing. And we cannot hide the blessings of God. We see that she had to put a rock in her heart, or make her heart a rock, and then she put him in the among the reeds of River Nile. There we find his sister. His sister was interested in her baby brother, and she watched over him. The Bible says she watched over him. Okay? Verse 4. His sister stood at a distance to see what would happen to him. She watched over him, what was going to happen to her baby brother, whether he's going to die or live. What is his fate? She was like a servant of God, waiting and watching over what God's blessings were. When God blesses us, you and I need to keep a watch over the blessing that He gives us. You know what? It's not easy. Let me tell you, when I teach in Sunday school, I share this story. I tell warrior for Christ, a servant for God, trying to look after her younger brother was not easy. In that swamp, among the reeds, there must be bugs of different kinds, maybe mosquitoes, or different kinds of insects must be biting her. She must be killing this side or that side, and yet kept an eye on her baby brother. Then what happened? She was faithful. Be faithful to the Lord in face of difficulty. He will help you. Yes, in the face of difficulty, she was very faithful to God and to her family and loyal to her brother. She kept watching over him. She kept watching over him. And he will see you through. God will see you through when you trust in him. There's a song, it says, through it all, I've learned to lean on Jesus through it all, and learn to depend on His word. Are we depending on Christ through all difficulties, problems that we may face, our circumstances, through it all? I've learned to depend on Jesus. I've learned to depend on His word, the word that Christ has given us. Are we willing to do that? Are we willing to trust in Him? Trusting in Christ is important. Then, I would like to share and tell you one thing. Be courageous and willing to work for Him. You know, as we read ahead in verse 5, the Pharaoh's daughter came along with her maid servants to have bath in River Nile. And they saw that basket. And she asked one of her servants or maids to bring the basket. And she saw the baby crying there. She adopted him. At that time, his sister was courageous enough. She had enough of courage to go up to the princess and say, "Should I get you a servant for this baby to look after, to nurse for you?" And it sounded good. What happened? The princess, "Go, get one." So when you and I are in the vineyard of God, when you and I as Christians, as believers, live, we need to have courage to share what God wants us to share. Even the gospel, our faith, we need to share with unbelievers. Be courageous enough to go up to the people and share what God wants us to do. Let's do it. That's exactly what happened. And then what happened is that God is no debtor of anyone. Remember, God is not a debtor. She looked after her brother in the reeds. She faced the insects and the bugs. She was bitten by mosquitoes and other things. Yet she did not give up. She was courageous enough to go up to the princess. And then what happens? God saw her faithfulness and rewarded her. Then God, my next point is, God gives back what we give to Him. Yes, I believe Moses' mother did what? She literally believed in God and gave up her son. Most probably she said a silent prayer, "Lord Jehovah, my provider, my banner, Jehovah Nishi, Lord, look after my baby. See to how this child, I give this child in your hand." What happened? God honored her faith. What she did? God blessed her. God gave her back her son. Not just like that, but with a blessing. A blessing to fulfill. What happens is this. Let's read it from verse number 8. Where in verse 7 says to her, to Pharaoh's daughter, shall I go and get one Hebrew woman to nurse your baby? And what says the princess is what? "Yes, go," she answered. And the girl went and got the baby's mother. Pharaoh's daughter said to her, "Take this baby and nurse him for me, and I will pay you." So the woman took baby and nursed him. When we give things to God, God gives us protection. If she would have kept Moses for a longer time in her house and not surrendered to God, what would have happened? Maybe he would have been killed. But when she gave him to God, In God's hand, God blessed Gemma back with protection and payment. God is faithful. He gives us back with extra blessing. Whatever we give, He blesses us and returns. That's why I said God is no debtor of anyone. He pays back. When you and I invest into the kingdom of God, our time, our talent, our finance, God pays back. Manyfold, He gives it back to us. And God does this. He did it for Moses' mother. Now she could flirt with her baby, move around in community. Why? Because God's hand was on him. He was being protected by the very enemy of his soul. God protects us in the face of our enemy. And our enemy becomes the one who gives us protection. Pharaoh's daughter announced that this baby is mine. I have adopted him. And therefore, Pharaoh's soldiers could not do anything to this baby called Moses. His mother was painted. Now, I would like to just give some comparison between Moses' life and our Lord Jesus Christ's life. We find that Moses was a foreshadow of Christ. He was typology or type of Christ in the Old Testament. An attempt was made to kill both. When Moses was born, that time babies were being killed by the who? The maids. They were being killed by midwives. And when Christ was born, what happened? This person, Herod the Great, tried to kill all the children in Bethlehem. They both ministered as prophets. Deuteronomy 18:15 says, Moses is speaking and says what? Lord will raise a prophet like me for you. And that was Christ. He also was a prophet. Again, both worked as priests. Moses was the one who ordained priesthood and he worked as a priest, a Christ. According to Hebrews chapter 7, verse 7, verse 24, it says that he is a priest. He is our priest. Christ is a priest. Then he was a king. Moses ruled as a king over the people for 40 years in the desert. And Christ is the King of Kings and Lord of Lords. Moses was a shepherd boy. As a shepherd, he worked for 40 years for his father-in-law as a shepherd. And Jesus, in John chapter 10, verse 11 to 14, says, I am the good shepherd. He is our shepherd. Moses delivered people from slavery of Egypt. Christ delivers us from the slavery of Satan and sin. And Moses gave the covenant, the Ten Commandments, where? On Mount Sinai for the people of Israel. Christ has given us a new covenant. And in His blood, we are saved. And He has purchased us a new covenant, a new heart He gives us. Shall we? Can we trust God like Moses' mother and sister and receive the blessing? Share the blessing and be faithful to Him. Be courageous and God will multiply our blessings. Shall we pray? Lord, we thank you and praise you this morning, Lord, for your grace. Lord, help us to be faithful to you, to receive our blessing and willing to give up what you want us from us, Lord. Thank you and we praise you. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.